The best-known story from the Minor Prophets is the amazing tale of Jonah and the whale, as it's popularly called. But the point of the prophecy of Jonah is more about Jonah and the worm. Jonah does his best to escape, but that's a tough thing to do when the God you're fleeing is, as Jonah calls him, the God who made the sea and the dry land. It seems your options are limited. At the time of Jonah's calling to preach to Nineveh, the capital of Assyria, that empire's looming shadow was falling on little Israel. These were the people who eventually would carry the 10 northern tribes into captivity. It was only a matter of time. After his famous detour, authenticated by the Lord Jesus as historical, he reluctantly preached to the Ninevites, who repented. This book is certainly more about God's message to the prophet than his message through him. The book provides a simple outline. Chapter 1, Jonah's problem. He tries to make good his escape, but nothing doing. First, he tries fleeing, and the storm catches him. Then he tries sleeping, and the captain catches him. Then he tries silence, and the lot catches him. Finally, he tries dying, and the fish catches him. In chapter 2, it's Jonah's prayer, where it's evident he really knows his Psalms. He missed the prayer meeting in chapter 1, but has lots of time to pray in chapter 2. Then in chapter 3, we have Jonah's preaching, and in chapter 4, Jonah's preparation. This is a book of turns. In chapter 1, the heathen sailors turn from idols to the true God. In chapter 2, Jonah turns from fleeing to following. In chapter 3, the people of Nineveh turn from their evil to the Lord, and in chapter 4, Jonah is displeased because the Lord turns away his wrath from the city. But the book ends with the messenger getting the message. The wideness of God's mercy, he's not willing that any should perish, even the people of Nineveh. And someday, the Lord will call the men of Nineveh as witnesses against those with greater privilege and a better message who refuse to repent. See Matthew 12:41. Now, Jonah rarely fares well at the hands of preachers. He's the reluctant prophet, the disobedient servant, the man who wanted the repentant Ninevites to perish anyway. But the Lord Jesus doesn't treat him like that. Twice he identifies with Jonah, both Jonah's predicament in the depths and Jonah's preaching, Matthew 12:39-41. The good news is God is still working with Jonah at the end of the book, which ends with a question. If Jonah cared about a biodegradable umbrella that grew and perished in a day, shouldn't God care about the creatures he made and cares for every day? The answer should be obvious, and we who love God should feel the same. And that's a scripture snapshot of the book of Jonah.